But there's a lot of things that turn me on in life is women, dinosaurs, and this.
Dinosaurs.
People that say you don't, that really make me going crazy.
Why
you know?
Dinosaurs?
No, but it's paleontology. Since I'm kidding,
I
study paleontology.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah, I traveled the world during those 4 years off, by the way.
Did you?
Yeah.
What did you do during those 4 years off?
I traveled a lot of the world on the site. On
sightseeing.
Yeah. I would never be that made me realize too that I could never be a paleontologist. I don't have the patience to go like
with a toothbrush
for hours. I would drive me. I like to get the knowledge of it, to be right on the field, to get the knowledge fast.
Right.
But I don't like to work to get the knowledge.
Right.
Which make me not a real paleontologist. The paleontologist is willing to put the work into it.
Yeah.
In MMA, I'm willing to put the work into it to become the champion, you know?
Yeah.
But in paleontology, that's how I because at one point I thought I liked both equally. Now I realize, no, I like the sport better.
The problem with the sport of MMA is so exciting. And paleontology is probably very exciting once you find like a T-Rex head or something like that.
It's the knowledge, man.
Yeah,
it's very,
the knowledge is exciting.
I have a thing in every month. Every time they have a discovery, it's in my phone.
Oh, like an app? Yeah.
Yes. Nice. Every time it's a new discovery or something, like, boom. And my friend, they make fun of me. They're like, man, you fight in a cage, you beat up people, and you like paleontology. What's wrong with you? Because they make fun of me. I went in Argentina, in Patagonia. I was there with paleontologists, biologists, and microbiologists on site, you know? And I had a blast, man. It was amazing. But people was like, George is gone in a freaking bad land and by him, like, alone, isolated for the rest of the world to do that kind of stuff, you know? So they were making fun.
Did you find anything?
I did not find it, but I went on site. I saw eggs. I saw sauropod remains, titanosaurs.
They're still in the ground when you were there? Like,
yeah,
they're finding it, excavating it.
Yeah, but Joe, it's a long process, man.
Yeah.
Has been covered for at least like 66 million years, man. You talk about like, and the place where I was, it was early to Cretaceous. No, it was late Cretaceous, but it was like 100 million years. So that's mean it did not get exposed to oxygen for 100 million years. That's why you got, it's like a crime scene, man. Where you go on these things, it's freaking there, man. It's like a crime scene that you discover, but like a 100 million years crime scene, man. You see these sauropods, man, these titanosaurs. It's insane, man.
Well, it's crazy too that it's not even really a bone anymore. The mineral has replaced the bone, and you just get the shape of the bone that's sort of been fossilized.
Yeah,
you know, like that's why if you see like megalodon teeth, they're black.
I have in my house the megalodon teeth.
Crazy, right?
Yeah, it's insane, man. Megalodon is like the strongest bite force ever recorded, man. It's crazy.
It's a big fucking animal. It was a huge fish.
Yeah, you feed on whales. Like,
yeah.
It's crazy. But like, this is one of the things that really excited me. So during those 4 years I was doing, man, I had a blast. I didn't have the time to do it before that. And I felt like it was missing in my life.
Really? Paleontology is missing in your life.
Yeah.
That's fascinating.
I went to Alberta. I went also in Dakota in the United States.
Oh, Dakota,
Now I want to go in Egypt. Egypt and Morocco. There was some site that there were once upon a time. It was like I'm talking about this, probably nobody cares, but I love it. There were like three giant apex predator living in the same, like a giant crocodile, Sarcosuchus, Carcharodontosaurus and Spinosaurus. These two live in the same area.
Wow.
I wonder what happened. Like three alpha freaking predators living at the same time. I wonder if they interact with each other and it must have been a crazy time, man.
I have a friend and one of his good friends has a ranch in Montana and he found something on the ranch, and he called this paleontologist, and they went to his ranch, and they shut the place down. Like, dude, you got a T-Rex here.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, Montana. Yeah.
They gave him over $1 million for it.
Yeah.
And they excavated this T-Rex in his ranch, and apparently it was a really good specimen.
In Canada, if you find something, it's part of it. It belongs to the government.
Let's say
you find a bone in your backyard. it doesn't belong to you.
Oh,
can you believe it?
That's fucked up.
Yeah, that sucked, man. It's very bad.
That's America's got you guys beat for that.
When I was young, Joe, I remember I used to live in countryside. I used to go and try to go to find bones, but I didn't know back then. I was not educated, so I thought maybe I could find dinosaurs. I was spending hours and trying to find dinosaurs. Every rock I took, I thought it was a dinosaur. I used to bring it back. And my mom is like, yeah, it's a dinosaur, Steve. Yeah, right there. Because it was kind of a triangular shape. But then I found out that all the place where I come from, it was all erosion. So there's nothing from Cretaceous or Jurassic or Triassic back then. It's all like before that. So it's all gone.
Yeah.
So it's just crazy, man. It's been a long time.